Are you struggling with how to organize related record data in your CRM? Hi, my name is Zach Spader, and today we're going to take a look at using subforms with a special focus on the field of lookup and aggregate formula functionality. Let's take a look. So subform functionality is not new in Zoho CRM. It's been out for several years now, and they continue to make updates to the functionality and add more features to it. It's a great way, if you have records that are related to another record, it's a great way to display those on the record. Before subforms, you would have to create a custom module and have a relate that to your primary module so that you could store data. And it was just a little more cumbersome in getting information into the system. With subforms, it makes it really easy to add additional records in, whether those are related records that you tie with a lookup field or they're just fields on a record that you use to store additional data. So today we're going to take a look at a couple of new features that subforms have within the last year or so. The first one is the field of lookup, and the second one is the aggregate formulas. So I have some products in my product module, and let's say that my process with my company is a little bit different. I don't issue quotes or sales orders. I just want to relate some products to a deal record that I have. And so I have my deal module here, and I want to be able to relate some products to this deal in a subform down at the bottom of the record. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to come in here to settings, and I'm going to go to modules and fields, and we're going to go to our deal module. And I'm going to drag a subform, a new subform, onto this record. We're just going to call it deal items. And what I want to do with this is I want to look up items from the product module. And so when I add my subform in, I can start adding my fields in. So I'm going to go ahead and add a field. And the first one that I'm going to add is a lookup field, because I want to look up to a record in the product module. So I'm going to select my module. We'll select products here. Okay. Now, once I've selected a lookup field, when I go to add additional fields, I have another option here up at the top. It's called Fields of Lookup module. And this allows me to pull information from the product module that's associated with the product that I'm looking up. So if I click on Fields of Lookup here, I have all the fields that are available to fill out in the product module available for me to put in here. So I'm going to click on description, go back in here, and I also want the rate. So that's the unit price. And then we're going to do something a little bit later where we're going to talk about the aggregate formula. So I'm going to add in the commission rate as well, because later on we're going to do a little aggregate formula based on commission rate. So commission rate. And then I just want a regular field to track the quantity. So I'm going to go back here, create a new field, and we're just going to make this a number field. And we're going to call this quantity. Typically, that's something we want to enter in at the beginning of the process. So we'll put that after the description. Okay. So let's test that out real quick. So if I click save on my record here, and I cancel out of this, I'm going to go back to my deal module. I'm going to go into my demo record here. Okay. Now I have my deal item section here. I'm going to go ahead and add some products in. So I'm going to click on the product looked up. And I've got a brown chair and I've got a white chair. So I'll just click on white chair. And you can see when I do that, because these are fields of lookup, they immediately bring in the description, the unit price, and the commission rate. So all I have to type in here is the quantity. And then I have all the information from the product right here in my deal module. Let's add one more row here. Okay, and then we'll save that record. So you can see Field of Lookup is really useful because you're able to bring other fields from the other module into your related subform here down at the bottom of the record. So that's a really neat feature. It'll save you a lot of time in having to re-enter data. You can just pull it right from the related records into your subform. So now let's make this subform a little bit more powerful and start adding some formulas into this. So what we want to do here, you can see that we have, for the first item here, we have a quantity of 2 and a unit price, but we're not getting a total price for that line item. We need to multiply the quantity times the unit price to get a total, like a line item total for this line. So let's go back into settings here. And I'm going to go back to my deal module. And first of all, let's just add a field in here to our subform. And we're just going to add a formula field. This is just a regular formula field, not an aggregate formula field. So we're creating a formula based on just the information in that line item in the subform. And so we're going to call this line item total. And then we're going to select our fields here. So I'm going to do quantity. And then we're going to multiply that. Oops. By unit price. Okay, so now we've got the line item total. And then let's take this one step further. For our aggregate formula later, we're going to calculate some commissions. So I'm going to also create a commission rate total as well for the line item, which we're going to basically do the same thing as the line item total. We're just going to take the commission rate times the quantity. So we'll go ahead and add a new field in, and we'll do another formula field. And again, this time we're going to take quantity. We're going to multiply it by commission rate. And we'll call this line item commission. Now, the aggregate fields down here at the bottom, you'll see that there's an option for an aggregate field. And so this is where we're going to calculate an aggregate total of all of the line items. So your regular formulas, if you just click the add field and click a regular formula, you can only pull in line items or fields from the actual line item itself. With the aggregate formula, you can pull in fields from all the different line items and total them together, multiply them, do whatever you want to do with them. You can either even take them times or divided by other fields within the module. They don't have to be fields within the subform itself. You can take it times a field in the module. Like let's say that you had a field in here that you calculated a percentage of the total deal. You could take that percentage and you could add an aggregate formula to calculate a percentage of that. So let's say that we're going to calculate out the total line item commission here. So this is a very simple one. We just add an aggregate field in here and we're just gonna do a sum of the line item commission. And we'll call this total commission. Okay, so we also want a total for the unit price as well. So we'll call this subtotal. And we want a sum of the line item total. And then let's add one more thing into this aggregate field. So let's alter the commission a little bit and say that we're only giving them the salesperson a percentage of the commissionable amount. So instead of calling this total commission, let's call this commissionable amount. And then let's say that let's alter this a little bit. Let's say that we have expenses in a deal, and we want to subtract those expenses from the commissionable amount. So this may be a travel. If you had to pay a salesman for travel or meals or something like that, you're going to subtract that amount from the commissionable amount. And so what we could do up here, let's add in a currency field. And let's call this expenses. Okay, we'll save that. As soon as we save that, the field will be available to us down in the formula field. So now let's add in another aggregate formula here. So this time what we want to do is we're going to create a formula based on the information that we have on the record. So we're going to take the total commissionable amount. So in here, we're going to look for that field. So we have commissionable amount, insert, and we're going to subtract. And now we're going to go up here and we're going to find our expenses. Here's our expenses right here. We're going to insert that in. And this is a great example of the aggregate formula. So you can use other information from the record that you're on to calculate out formulas based on the subform fields. I'm going to click done here, and we're going to save this. Oh, you know what? Let's call this final commission. Okay, let's cancel out of here and go back to our demonstration deal. And we'll scroll down to our subform here. And you can see that we don't have those formulas on these items that we entered. And that's because we entered these in before we added the formula fields. And so all we have to do here is just click edit on the record and then save it again. And once we save it, we pull in all this other information. So you can see now it's calculating out our line item totals and our commissions correctly. We're getting a commissionable amount down here at the bottom, which is just the sum of the line item commission. We're getting the subtotal, which is the subtotal of the line item total here. And we're getting the final commission amount. And so notice the final commission amount here, 102.97, is the exact same as the commissionable amount. And so in this particular case, this based on this expenses field. So let's say that I had expenses of $50. And once I save that, then you can see that my final commission amount changes down here in the aggregate formula. So we've gone over a couple of new functionalities today. We've gone over the field of lookup, which allows you to bring additional information into subform records that you add to a module. And we've gone over the formulas and the aggregate formulas, which are both very powerful tools in your use of subform. So I hope this video has been helpful. Have a great day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.